folks, and welcome to the start of something massive. The biggest challenge I've ever undertaken. The PS1 Platinum Project. 160 games, 365 days. Let the games begin. Hit the music. Welcome to the very first episode of my challenge for 2023, the PlayStation Platinum Project. My journey to collect all 160 Platinum release games for the PlayStation 1 in the PAL region. It is going to be a hell of a ride, and I'm super excited to take all of you viewers along for the ride. I'm going to be going all around the UK to charity shops, game shops, CX, car boots, anywhere I can get my hands on these 160 PlayStation 1 Platinum games. It is a tall order, but with your help, I think the impossible can be achieved. To complete this challenge in 2023, I'm going to need your help. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button, subscribe, and please consider sharing this to your socials. This project is all about teamwork. It's about reaching out to the retro gaming community here in the UK and further afield to complete this challenge. Without a lot of help of you and the community in general, I will never complete the PlayStation Platinum Project. So please, I need your help. Let's make this work. Let's get into the rules of this challenge then. And basically, there are no rules. I will do anything to get my hands on these Platinum games. I will head to charity shops, car boots, CX stores around the UK, gaming stores around the UK. And even better than that, I'm going to be reaching out to you watching. Yes, you. If you have Platinum games you do not want, I want them. I'm up for buying any unloved Platinum games to add into my collection. I'm also up for trading. I always have a pile of trades, and I'll be sharing it periodically on my YouTube page and my socials. So if you see anything you want from my trade list and you have Platinum games on offer, let's make a deal. You may be asking yourself, why the PlayStation Platinum Project? Why go after these Platinum games? And the thing is, I think these get a bad rep. A lot of people hate on the Platinum range, myself included, over time. But here is the thing with the Platinum range. It is the very best the PlayStation 1 has to offer. All of these 160 games, to reach that mark of becoming a Platinum game, have had to sell over 400,000 copies in the PAL region. So if I collect all 160 of these games, I will have the best cross-section of PlayStation 1 games in my collection possible, and it will make an absolutely amazing PS1 collection. As I said then, there is 160 games in the PS1 Platinum collection, but thankfully I've been collecting PlayStation games for many, many years, and we are not starting from the bottom. We already have quite a solid framework to begin with. Here we have it then, the 36 games we are starting off with. There's some fairly decent titles here like Crash Team Racing, Die Hard Trilogy, some of the kind of higher priced games as well like Grand Theft Auto, which you may notice I have two copies of, as because as well I have that as a variant. But here is the thing, we are 36 games down but 124 to go. And what better place to start the hunt than the UK's biggest gaming market? We're starting off our Platinum hunt, this time at Doncaster Gaming Market. The biggest gaming market in the UK, and you could tell by the crowds outside this was going to be a huge market and a great way to get the Platinum Project started, or so I thought. I have done a full game hunt here, I'll leave a link in the description below for that video. First stall then, and we are straight away finding some PlayStation Platinum games. Jumping straight in, this was really useful how these games were labelled. They were all like kind of wrapped in plastic, but it told you on the front of the game if they were complete or if they had parts missing. One of these games I picked up straight away, but trust me, this is the start of my bad luck on the games hunt today. I managed to pick up the same game, not once, but twice. That's the thing about these games markets, they are really, really overwhelming. They are loud, they are crowded, and it's really hard to kind of keep your concentration all the way through. But there were some really good games here at really good prices, so I wanted to grab at least one from this first stall, but I knew there was a lot more Platinum games out there for the hunt. Here lies the problem with gaming markets. There is a lot of games here, but the thing is, I need a lot of games. There is 160 Platinum games for the PlayStation 1, and there was a lot of these games here, but I am looking for games still to be in good condition, complete and for a good price. And the thing is, I could have picked up a lot of games here straight away, but also I don't have an infinite amount of money. Like, I can only pick up so many at a time, and I was also aiming for other games for the collection, so I am looking for the best prices. So I do think I passed up on quite a few games here I probably should have picked up, but as I said, these gaming markets are very overwhelming. It's really hard to concentrate on what you're doing. And trust me, I made quite a few mistakes here, but I'm sure we're going to rectify these mistakes down the way. But the thing is, it's good to see there are lots of platinum games out there on the market. I know a lot of people prefer the black label games, but we are here for the platinum project. We may be off to a bit of a rocky start, but trust me, there's a long way to go on that road to the full collection. Another box of mixed PlayStation 1 games down here. One that did stand out for me was Colin McRae Rally, but at £8, I think that is a title that we can get a lot cheaper down the line. And that is the thing, we are going to see a lot of these games multiple times, and it's deciding how long to hang out for that cheaper deal on a game. There's going to be some games we can't pass on, but some we can wait for a cheaper deal on. The next store had an absolutely massive selection of PlayStation 1 games, both Platinum and also Black Label. I was very tempted by their Ace Combat, which just disappeared next to me. Literally, the person just in front of me bought that just before I was going to buy it. That was definitely one of the games that are on the list, as I'm really looking for games, first and foremost, that I've never played on a PlayStation 1 before or have in my collection. Games such as Destruction Derby Raw. Now, I think this was down for £15. I did try and haggle him down to a tenner. Unfortunately, he wouldn't accept the offer, but this is one of the things. I'm trying to get a deal on most of these games, so hopefully this is one we can find further down the road on the road to the Platinum Project. It's actually surprised me how some of these Platinum games have become a lot more valuable. Games such as Medal of Honor Platinum, I'm sure for a few years ago you could pick this up for a couple of quid. It's here for £8. I did decide to pass on this one, which may have been a mistake, as this is one of the many PlayStation 1 Platinum games that CX no longer sells. I wonder if this is going to make some of these games a lot more expensive. Here is my second big mistake of the day. They had some really good Platinum games here for a really good price, and I pass these up as I wasn't really sure the market value. I could have picked up both Tony Hawk's 2 and Tony Hawk's 4 here. I think these were up for £3 or something. I really should have picked these up. This is something I'm going to have to do along the way, is learn some of the market values of these PlayStation Platinum games. A lot of these I thought would be a lot cheaper. Obviously, I've kind of got my market knowledge wrong, but this is something I'm definitely going to have to work in if we're going to get on the way to that full Platinum collection. Definitely made some mistakes here, but I'm sure there's still time to rectify them down the line. Now, this is my biggest mistake of the day, and I'm going to kind of make my excuses now because it was very late in the day. I was very tired, my brain was fried, but I should have grabbed so many more of these games. There is 160 games on this list for the complete Platinum collection, and all of these games were £3 each. I should have absolutely filled my bags with these. This would have been such a good way to start the Platinum project, just picking up loads of these games. I just regret not doing it. I could have crossed 10 games off the list for just £30, but I think this was early days, and I really underestimated how much some of these Platinum games were going to cost. But this is the thing, the entire Platinum project is going to be a learning curve. It is going to be kind of learning from our mistakes, learning the values of games, and just kind of growing as a person along the way. At the end of the day, some of these games' cases were a little bit cracked. Some of them weren't complete. But this is the thing, I'm also going for quality, not just quantity. I want the game case to be in good condition, to be fully complete. And at the end of the day, a lot of these games are quite common. And there is a long road ahead. And trust me, we are going to find all of these games eventually. I'm just going to stick to the plan over the course of 2023. And eventually, we will get to that full Platinum collection of 160 games. It is going to be a hell of a ride. Nearly at the end here, and I did pick up this copy of Cool Borders 4 for £3. I thought it was a good one to not pass up, and I've never actually played this Cool Borders game. I think it was the last one released, so hopefully it's the best of the four. Couple other games here, I'm always on the lookout for other stuff as well as looking for Platinum stuff, but obviously at times you can see somebody really wanted that game. You can tell at times I'm mainly going to be looking for Platinums, but I'm always looking for other stuff at the same time. Here we have the final mistake of the day. I was going for this box. I think these were all £1 or £2. And you can see I pick up another copy of Call Borders 2 and a copy of Toka, which we already had in the collection. Now back to the games room to check out the first platinum pickups.
Here we are then, back in the games room then from Doncaster Gaming Market. And unfortunately, it was a bit of a rocky start to this, the PlayStation Platinum project, because unfortunately, straight out of the gate, I have managed to pick up games you already had in the collection. So I picked up this copy of Toka Touring Car. Unfortunately, we already have this in the games collection, so this one is a bit of a fail. Not only that, but I managed to pick up not one, but two copies of Call Borders 2. The game's so good, I've decided to pick it up twice, but this is the thing, with some of these games conventions, you are under a lot of pressure. They are very overwhelming and mistakes can be made. I will be keeping this copy on the right hand side in my collection, but good news for you viewers, this copy on my left is now in my trade pile. So hit me up if you want to trade this for another platinum game. Finally, we have Call Borders 4. So here's the thing, out of the four games we picked up from Doncaster Gaming Market, we need two of these games for the collection. So this takes us down to 122 games on the list. But here's the thing, I could have picked up a lot more at the games convention, but this is not a sprint, it is a marathon. It's going to be the whole of 2023, and trust me, I'm going to get straight back on that horse. So let's head to my local city of Norwich and get straight back on the hunt.
We're starting a platinum hunt in Norwich in my local CX, and I'm trying to check out these PlayStation 1 games. As I could see on their website, they had a copy of both Tekken 2 and Soul Blade. Now, spoiler alert, unfortunately they couldn't even find the copy of Soul Blade, which it said was in stock online, and a copy of Tekken 2 had a massive crack in it. So for today, the search continues. Next up, I headed to a local record shop, which also sells games, DVDs, etc. They had this copy of Time Crisis, but $7.95. I think this is one I can pick up cheaper. I've seen this one quite often for about a fiver, so I did decide to pass up on it. But I am always looking for other games, as I said, to add to the collection. That Mass Effect box set was in pretty good condition and for a pretty decent price. They did have some other PlayStation 1 games, but nothing that really stood out. I was tempted to pick up this PS3 Batman game, as it is a steelbook, but I didn't pick any more games up here. Next up on the hunt, I went to my local Cash Converters, and whilst they did have a lot of PlayStation 1 games in here, for the first time ever someone's going to say this, sadly they were all Black Label and no Platinum games. I was quite tempted to pick up this game because it looked like it was a rental copy, but at £15 for a game I don't really know anything about, I did pass up. But let me know if I made a mistake. We're concluding today's game hunt in my local game store, Last Level Games. And finally, a large amount of Platinum games. So here we have Aladdin, Something's Revenge, that was £5. That one didn't have the front on. I did pick up Fade to Black for £3. Yes, some of these cases need a little bit of TLC, but some Goo Gone will get rid of some of these extra stickers on here. I was just glad to be finding a decent amount of games for cheap, like In Cold Blood for £5. This is an absolutely fantastic game. This one was in really good condition. For £5, I was definitely picking that one up. These are the kind of games which I am going to be looking for. PGA Tour 96 for £2. These are some of the games that are going to be nice and easy to add to the collection and cheap. I was just glad to kind of end this week's hunt on a high. Even though I did find a copy of The Jungle Book again, a game which originally was not on our list, but I guess we're at 161 now. With this series, I really want to concentrate on supporting local game stores. So I wanted to pick up a couple of slightly higher value games from Last Level Games to kind of round off today's hunt. So we're going to head back to the games room now, and I'm going to show you which of these games I picked up. But see if you can guess before we head back. But now, back to the games room.
Here we are then, back once again in the games room. Before we get into the pickups from today's game hunt, I want to go through the contents of this box here. As this is super exciting, as this is the first viewer trade for the Platinum project. So in this box, I have three games which I traded from games from my swap pile. It's a fantastic way for both me and you viewers to build your collections. And don't worry, if you haven't got any games to trade, I'm still happy to pay for any Platinum games you don't want from your collection. So reaching into this box, first off we have FIFA 99. Yes, not the most exciting title, but there is 160 games and this is one of them, and I want to add them all, so the FIFAs need to be in the collection. Next up, we have an absolute PlayStation 1 classic, Colin McRae Rally. This was one of those games I think every single person who owned a PlayStation 1 played at some point. But let me know in the comments down below if you have never played this amazing PS1 rally game. Speaking of absolutely iconic PlayStation 1 racing games, No collection is complete without Toka Racing Cars 2. Again, a game that I think everyone at least played a demo of back in the day, but one we definitely need off the list. As I said, any games off this platinum list that you have, I'm interested in. It's not just the big titles, it is the titles like these. It is that whole 160 games that make the PS1 Platinum Project possible. Finally, before we get into today's platinum pickups, we have these two pickups off eBay, and these were both £4 plus postage. And here's the thing, if I can get games cheaper off eBay than I can in CX, I am going to grab them, even though this first one, seemingly at first, was a mistake. I picked in this copy of Grand Theft Auto for the PS1, the platinum version. So I picked this up for £4, but the thing is, this trades in to CX for £12. Now, when I realised my mistake, I did try and cancel my order with the seller, but unfortunately they had already sent it, but I can use this £4, tripling my money into CX to buy more platinum games for the collection. Secondly, we have Wipeout 2097, and this is the kind of game I'm going to be specifically looking to pick up first. I have never played this game on the PlayStation 1, and this is one of the best things about the PlayStation Platinum Project, is playing these games I have never played before. And trust me, that is what I'm going to do right now. For the first time ever, I'm going to check out Wipeout 2097. This, folks, is what the PlayStation Platinum Project is all about. Playing the games, not just adding them to the collection, but expanding my knowledge of the PlayStation back catalogue. There is 160 games in this Platinum Project, and there is countless games that I have never played before. And I cannot believe I have never played one of the most iconic racing games on the PS1. And this is what it's all about, going back and playing these games properly in the way they're intended to be played on this old school CRT Sony Trinitron TV and reliving some of the best games the PS1 has to offer. Here we have our final pickups from the day then, and these are all from my local game store, Last Level Games. And here is something I really want to emphasize with this series, the importance of local game stores and how much we need to support our local game stores, especially in the financial climate at the moment. Trust me, use them or lose them, and that is why I wanted to grab as many platinum games as I could from this game store and in future for more game stores around the UK. So if one of your local game stores is full of platinum games, please let me know. I'm gonna be on the road a lot more this year and I will hit it up. So first off, we have PGA Golf 96. These are the kind of games that are fantastic to pick up as filler games. This was £2 and it's just another game to cross off the Platinum Project list. Next up, we have another EA Classics game. And the thing is, these are some of the worst looking artwork for these PlayStation Platinum games, but it's just what EA decided to do with these. This one again was quite a cheap pickup, £3. This goes to show a lot of the games on this list can be bought pretty cheaply, so hopefully it'll make the list a little bit easier to complete. This final cheap game is In Cold Blood, an often overlooked game on the PlayStation 1. Very similar to Metal Gear Solid, it doesn't get anywhere near the amount of love that Absolute Classic does. I'm not comparing them quality-wise, but this is still a bit of an overlooked gem. And this is the kind of game I really want to kind of highlight in this Platinum Project. As you saw at the end of that live game hunt, there was a glass cabinet absolutely full of amazing PlayStation 1 games. I wanted to pick up a few of these slightly more expensive games. These are kind of middle games. Here we have one of my favourite strategy games of all time, Command & Conquer Red Alert. And this, as well as the other games I'm about to show you, is an absolute amazing condition from Last Level Games. They really go the extra mile to give you the games in the best condition. I don't mind taking off some of these labels for some of these cheaper games, but when I can get a game like Red Alert in this kind of condition for just £10 from my local game store, it's rude to shop elsewhere. The next game I picked up from Last Level Games is this absolute classic, Tekken 2. And it may surprise you that once again, this is another game which I have never played on the PS1. And this again is the advantage of the Platinum Project, is to go back and play some of these games that I missed. The reason I missed this one is I only ever played Tekken 3 on the PS1. Playing on a demo, my friend picked this game up on launch day, but I'm definitely looking forward to going back and playing this one. The eagle-eyed among you might have noticed as well, I did try and find this in CX, but it had a massive crack. This just goes to show your local game store takes a lot of care and attention to their games. The final pickup this time is another classic beat-em-up, which again I tried to get in CX, but thankfully was able to pick up in Last Level Games, Soul Blade. Another game I never played back on the PS1, and I cannot wait to jump into this one. I'm just kind of glad that I actually didn't pick these games up from CX. I'd much rather spend my money in his local game shop. So as I said earlier, if you have a game shop local to you that has a high selection of Platinum games, let me know and I'll be on the road. There we have it then, folks. The first episode of the PlayStation Platinum Project. 12 games added to the 36 we already had means we are at 48. 112 games to go. But trust me, this is just the beginning. This is going to be a long road to that 160 to complete the PlayStation Platinum Project. But now, the best bit. Crossing them off the list and adding the games to the collection. There we have it then, folks. That is the end of this first episode of the PlayStation Platinum Project. And you have the power to make this series and this challenge a success. Hit that like button, subscribe, tell all your friends. As a community, we can complete this challenge together. This is the first stop on a very long road to that complete PlayStation Platinum collection. Thank you for watching. Let the games begin. See you soon.